Pediatricians actually ate pieces of Lego and pooped them out, all in the name of science. Welcome to Inform Overload, I'm your host Johnny Rogers, and if you're new to the channel, we find the most interesting news stories on the internet and we make them more entertaining. Ah, science, what will they come up with next? A small group of pediatricians got together to solve the age-old question of how long does it take to poop out Lego pieces? If you're wondering, the answer is on average it takes 1.71 days to poop out those little yellow Lego heads. For the sake of science, six pediatricians all volunteered to consume a Lego head and search through their poop to find the evidence. Before undergoing this serious scientific endeavor though, the healthcare professionals had to have not had gastrointestinal surgery and has to be perfectly fine with, well, going through their own feces. The final results were published in the Journal of Pediatrics and Child Health in an article they titled, which is so funny how they titled this, "Everything is awesome, don't forget the Lego." Amazing. Shout out to the Lego Movie fans who had a good laugh at that title, just like me. It gets better though, and this is the kind of funny news that you just can't write. The volunteers were monitored for their pre-ingestion bowel habits to account for any differences in the study. The standardized test is called the Stool Hardness and Transit, or the SHAT score. Wait, hold on guys, it gets better. The time in which it takes for the Lego piece to travel from the mouth to the toilet bowl is called the found and retrieved time, also known as the fart score. Ah, and just like that, I feel like a kid again. Poop jokes are always funny. Like I said, it takes approximately 1.71 days for that Lego piece to leave the body, and a fart score that falls between 1.14 and 3.04 days. Unfortunately for one of the male volunteers, he never found the Lego head he consumed. Which leads the researchers to come to the conclusion, and I quote, "Females may be more accomplished at searching through their stools than males." Although this test seems crazy, hilarious, and whatever else you want to think about it, the study was done with a purpose. The reasoning for this scientific study is to put the minds of the parents at ease when their child decides that dinner just wasn't enough for them. Now, with the study, they can be sure that consuming a Lego piece won't have nasty health complications for their child. The authors of the study also wrote something worth keeping in mind though. They said, "It is possible that childhood bowel transit time is fundamentally different from adult, but there is little evidence to support this, and if anything, it is likely that objects would pass faster in a more immature gut. This will be of use to anxious parents who may worry that transit times may be prolonged and potentially painful for their children." The authors also urge parents that if a child does eat something like this and it doesn't show up in the feces, to not go looking for it. Also, I urge you, as funny and important as this study is, we do not give you the green light to start eating Lego pieces. If an experienced PhD couldn't find the piece in their own stool, you should not expect that you could. With that, I want to leave a question for you. Do you think this study is important, or was it a waste of time? Now let's move on to some featured comments from the video titled, "You'll Never Use a McDonald's Touchscreen Again After Hearing This." The Sage 2020 says, "There's fecal matter everywhere, no big deal, from your phones to your toothbrush." Okay, gross, but also true. I need to sanitize my body now. Mr. Walrus says, "Well, that's a crappy situation." I love a good pun. Good on you, Mr. Walrus. J-Hope Hobby says, "Well, goodbye McDonald's and hello Burger King. Or, and bear with me here, get grass-fed beef from a local butcher and make homemade burgers. It'll taste better, it'll be cheaper, and in the long run, you'll be supporting local businesses. Plus, it's just better meat." Tanzanite the One says, "Gross, oh my god, Potato King." Hey, I feel the same way. Poop on McDonald's touchscreen is very gross. The Deshaun Allen says, "Real talk, who really goes inside a fast food restaurant? It's drive-thru only over here." This man right here is a genius. Why did we ever leave the drive-thru? I guess if you live in a city, it's hard to find them, but just talk to the cashier. They work at McDonald's. I'm sure as gross as you think your order is, they've seen worse. Thank you for watching Inform Overload. Hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. And if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe before you leave. Also, if you want more videos like this one, just click the floating playlist on the screen. And if you have any hot tips on any new and exciting stories that you want us to cover, find my Instagram in the description below and send me a DM. From Inform Overload, I'm Johnny Rogers, and until next time, take care.